Gosh, Tony said not to come to this door, man. Oh, who's this now? Hi, my name's Maxine. I just came to talk about the Mormons. I'm a Mormon.
The Mormons? The Mormons, let me see. Oh, aye, the Mormons. You're the ones from Disneyland, is that right?
No. Well, some of us are, but actually we're from America.
Fantastic America. One of my favourite places. So why don't you come in for a cup of tea then, and we can have a wee chat?
Well, read the t-shirt. I can't come in for a cup of tea. We're not allowed to.
Nonsense, Maxine. Come away in and sit down in the living room there. Put your feet up and, yeah, I'm just making a brew just now, so do you take sugar milk?
Well, alright, I'll come in, but you can just get me a glass of milk, would that be okay?
Absolutely fine, Maxine, and I promise I won't charge you anything.
Alright, I'll just sit down over here, thank you.
That's kind of chilly out there, isn't it, Maxine?
Man, I need to make an impression with this girl away. I'm not going to give her.
I know what I'll give her. I'll give her my Mickey Mouse cup that I got for my birthday last year. She'll like that. Mormons like Mickey Mouse and all that kind of stuff. I need to make a good impression with this girl. Hey.
Yep, just coming.
Sure, Maxine. Tell me what you're doing in Scotland. Do you like my Sean Connery impression, Maxine? You impressed?
Yeah, I'm just out doing some evangelism for the Mormon Church, you know. Do you know anything about the Mormons?
Let me see. Joseph Smith, is that right? Is that the man that's founded the movement? Am I correct in saying that?
Yeah, I'm impressed so far, you know. So what else you know?
Oh, okay. I can't tell what I think of Joseph Smith. Okay, yeah, Joseph Smith's a very, very nice guy here.
I said he translated the Book of Mormon and, you know, started the movement and it grew and grew and grew until, you know, it's a very, very family-orientated movement and, you know, we love having lots of kids.
Okay, so how about you, Maxine? Have you got any children?
Actually, I don't. I'm looking for a husband so that I can start, you know, having lots of children, actually.
Okay then, so what exactly do I have to do to join the Mormons? I mean, I hear Joseph Smith had maybe exaggerated 20 or 30 wives, maybe just 2 or 3. What do you think of that?
Well, we don't actually practice polygamy anymore.
So, well, for example, Maxine, let's just say, for instance, you know, let's just say I joined the Mormons then, and I liked one of the girls at the Mormon church. How long would it take me to get married to one of these girls, such as yourself, maybe?
Actually, you know, I can't get married, you know, for a couple of years because I have some commitments that are things I need to do. I'm a committed missionary, so I'm not allowed to get married until I finish up being a missionary.
Well, I mean, I guess you could come along to the Mormon church next week, next Sunday, and, you know, we're having a service there, so will you come? 2 years. 2 years. Is there any way around that actual 2 year thing?
No, I'm sorry, Jambap. No, I can't. I gotta wait at least 2 years, you know. I made a commitment to my family and my God, so I got to honor that. You understand, don't you?
Well, yeah, of course I understand, you know, of course. I'd be more than glad to come to your service on Sunday, unless, you know, I've got anything else on, which I don't think I have, but, you know, hey, I'll try and make it, you know what I'm saying? It would be good.
Yeah.
Right then, Maxine, just see you at the door there, so just watch yourself on the way out there, and, you know, don't talk to any strangers, will you? And I'll see you on Sunday, all right?
Oh, I can't do that, of course, I'm a Mormon. Alright, I'll see you on Sunday, Jambap.
Seemed like a very nice girl. Even took her shoes off at the door.
Yeah, I suppose you can see Joseph Smith's point, all these beautiful women in America, and he had all these wives. Oh my goodness. And this girl, she just wants one husband and a few children, and she's very, very... nice girl, very kind of, I don't know, has morals, and
yeah, you can see she's an attractive girl as well. Yeah, she's pretty good.
I didn't even mention my faith in Jesus to her. I didn't even mention my faith in Jesus to her. God,
forgive me, Lord, but I guess if I see her the next time, I definitely will mention my faith in you, okay? I definitely will.
Who can this be at this time? 6 a.m. Who's going to come round at my door at this time except the milkman? I don't even get milk. Okay, I'm coming. Hey, Mr. Jambab. Yeah, well, guess what? I just couldn't sleep last night. I've been thinking all about what you said, and I want to become a Christian.
Tony from yesterday, the Jehovah's Witness. This can't be real, surely.
They don't become Christians that easily, do they?
Okay, Tony, so you want to become a Christian? Are you ready to give up everything for Jesus Christ? Are you ready to lay your life down for him and accept him as your Lord and Savior this morning?
Yes, I am, sir. Yep, I'm ready to do all that.
Can you share a little bit with me about what actually made you want to become a Christian in this short length of time?
Well, a combination of things, Jambab, but the main thing was, last night, while I was praying, I asked God if Jesus was his son, and if what you were saying was true. And I went to sleep, and I actually saw an angel speaking to me, telling me that, woe to me if I don't believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and that he died for my sin. And this angel was a very huge angel, so I'm coming down here. I know I have to fear God now and that my soul is in his hands.
Well, praise Yahweh, Tony. Yes, we'll go through the sinner's prayer this morning. And I would also like to give you a King James Version Bible where you can actually study the scriptures with us at least twice a week. And basically we'll ask Jesus into your life. I'll pray for you. I'll anoint you. And you can decide if you want to do water baptism, which is about basically repenting of your sin, making your vessel holy, and then for you to go and seek Yahweh's anointing yourself. Because all of us have our own relationship with the Lord, and I'm certain that he's got a calling on your life, Tony.
Yes, sir, I hear you. Because, you know, the other vision I saw last night was like, there was this dark shadow over the Kingdom Hall, and you know the angel showed me that that the Holy Spirit was not in the Kingdom Hall. That we in fact didn't have the Holy Spirit. We didn't seek God's anointing, and the angel just told me that darkness would soon come in the kingdom of the beast. And people would actually gnaw their tongues. So we know that there's such a fallen angel as Lucifer. And it's actually, you know, the prince of darkness now. So, you know, he's went out and deceived many. And I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord. And that the founder of the Jehovah's Witnesses is a satanic false prophet.
Amen, Brother Tony. Amen.
Thank you.
Bob, I was kind of lonely and just thought I could pop around and see you. Is that okay?
Aye. Oh, wrong picture. Well, in fact, I'll not be able to come this Sunday because my bitch has just had some puppies. So I'll tell you what, I'll give you one of the puppies and I'll see you next week.